No, but I really need this thing away from the lunatics. From what I've heard, that promotes longevity big time. I set it to lay out quickly and found a promising row of shelves just about to the side of the Hall Center. Great, that's my path of salvation. I retreat back to the cereal shelf and get ready for a daring escape. I calculate the air movement in the room, measuring the temperature difference. Then I stick to the leeway side but to bypass the target. A wave of sweet flurries. Ouch! I really mean it! The impact makes the world before my eyes turn pitch black for a moment. That explains the flying green ball coming at our face. When I got to my senses, I tried to learn what I got into in every way. Ooh, the bunnies! Naturally, I am sitting on the floor, and all the packs and boxes are carefully selected, belted around in picture square chaos. And in the midst of all this, panty shot, in a comparably picture square pose, I see. This lady. Kilt. Watch where you're going! Just, how come she's here? I'm sure I was heading away from her. The girl jumps up and grabs a carton from the floor. Before I can think of anything to say, she simply leaps over me. I only catch a glimpse of the red coat disappearing behind the soda cooler. Hey! Hey! Those are my noodles! Seriously, June? Noodles? Is that all you care about at the moment? I'm left alone with the scattered boxes. So, what do I do now? I mean, that's a rhetoric question. It's clear as day. I have to put those goods where they belong. Else, I'll have to find a new spot to get my groceries from. Oof! I'm just too good at making first impressions memorable. Ah, that girl though! Ah! What's the problem? As I sort the packs and boxes through, I get more and more aggravated over this embarrassing encounter. Watch where you're going? Oh, really? Well, I have an idea. But if you watch where you're going, you little Himetsamaya Josan. I, for one, was watching, like, real hard. To give anything to, and not to see her ever in my life. Anything but my noodles. But she took them away! Oh! She certainly is the perverted type! And I don't want it dead! Oh! Just so that she thinks she is! Actually, I have a couple ideas on that too! Time flies by as I come up with possible witty answers, which I will most definitely use next time. I refill my basket and tidy up everything that fell off the shelf, but there's still plenty of goods left on the floor. These are probably from the girl's basket. The basket itself is lying here on the floor too, abandoned by its flamboyant hostess. Could have at least taken it with her. Okay, let's see. That's chemicals! Chemicals! And even more chemicals! High glycerin of Clan Chu! She's what? She's trying to get rid of a body? My dead body, possibly! Why, of course. Whose else body could it be? It starts coming together now. This girl is definitely a crazy fan. Probably a Yandere or something. She's going to lock me in her basement! Mentally crush me! Possibly crush me with her tags! They'll all kinds of blood stuff until I offer her the ever-blooming flower of a forbidden love! The girl and girl thing! And if I refuse... Ah! This is too much! Are you alright? No! I mean, yes! That is... Suddenly, I know what I should do. I'm sorry. Do you know that girl in the red coat? She was here just a few minutes ago, buying noodles. It's a small town. I doubt there are tons of stores around. If my parent is a local, the saleswoman must know her. You mean Lady Ren? Of course I know her. Everyone here does.
Lady?
What do you mean by that? Lady Ren is the heiress to Fukuyama clan. They are our patrons. Their sawmill is the only thing that keeps this town afloat. Of course, things got a little messy lately, but if it wasn't for them, everything here would have fallen apart long ago.
A little messy? What do you mean?
Oh, it's nothing. I'm just talking, you know. We're living away from the rest of the world, and life here can get difficult at times. Sometimes you just get a little bored, and sometimes... Oh, by the way, you only just arrived, haven't you? I'm pretty sure I haven't seen you here before.
Who? Me? Yes! Got here just yesterday!
My, is that so? Please excuse me for being pushy. There's really not much happening around. You're always welcome here. We do love new faces.
Oh! Well, that's great!
Haha! We chat a bit more, but I only had the strength to dodge the countless questions. It's a shame that I'm missing out on the opportunity to get a better feel for everything. But I can't help it. Everything has happened. Too much and too fast. I have no idea what to make of it all. Finally, I pay for my purchase, get outside, and then...
I like how this actually is like really completely different from the other one.
The other one, well, we didn't exactly get much. We did, of course, fight Ren, but in this, well, this is different. It's hard to explain. I'm not really good at it. And that's pretty cool. Had she been eavesdropping all this time? Good thing I tried to not talk too much. But what's wrong with this girl? What is it you want from me, Fukuyama Ren? Maybe I should get up there and ask this question in person. I considered the idea but arrived at no conclusion. It may be reasonable, but right now I want nothing more than to be at home, alone with delicious hot lunch. After all, if my stalker was in the mood for a conversation, she wouldn't have run away from it, right? Just who knows what's in her mind, really. Money and fame make people go bananas, and this Lady Rien might be both the richest and the most famous here. I can't let my guard down, but I should try and keep from going bananas myself. The saleswoman did pounce on me with tons of questions, but all in all, she's quite nice.
Yeah,
at least I don't feel like I moved to some creepy cult village or something. And that girl, who knows, maybe she got overly excited to see a newcomer. Well, now that she's seen enough of me at various angles, maybe she'll leave me alone. That thought in mind, I head home. White fog. Nothing but white fog and a voice. Oh, I can skip. Okay. What if I call again? If I'm lucky, there'll be enough energy to make one more call. There should be enough. This can't. I held the power button on my phone until it hurts. It feels like a piece of ice. Come on, please. This one call. The window glass shakes slightly, and striking breaks into a high-pitched squeal. That thing is no longer outside the window. It's here in the house. It is the house itself. This can't be the end. The phone screen lights up. Oh, the thing, I just tap it. A familiar number. A call button. I hold the phone to my ear. The voice is barely audible because of the terrible static. Fukuyama! It's not Fukuyama. You already know that. Just why do you always keep pretending and lying to yourself, June?
You motherfucker!
The screeching and squealing merge into a piercing cry of pain. There been no living being can withstand. Problematic smartphone use. What if I checked the open spread that says it's not a book, more like a diary? Or some kind of a scrapbook? The page spread is filled with neat newspaper clippings. Each clipping has the name of the newspaper and the date next to it. Some words of the clippings are underlined. At first, I only pay attention to them, but it doesn't make sense. I start reading in a row. Fire at the Fukuyama sawmill. Managed to put it out. No casualties. That was like 60 years ago? At first, I think it's just a compilation of accidents and incidents, but there are other clippings too. Much stranger ones. They contain weather and temperature data. Why would anyone be interested in this? So, fire happened at a workplace of theirs. Some of these clippings have arrows pointing at the incident reports. 50 years ago, mid-spring, heavy frost, two people froze to death in the woods. They mumble something in their sleep and starts moving. Okay, cool. I rummage through the closet for simple towels, but I can't get those newspaper clippings out of my head. Seems like over time, the climate grew colder and colder around here, and the incidents ended up getting worse and worse? But why? Could a cursed house affect this? But Rin said all the dark energy is locked up in here, with a magic seal or something. On the other hand, why that thing was knocking on the window? Like, is the backyard also considered part of the house?
Silly ghosts!
I can't help but shudder at the thought of last night. I do better keep my thoughts away from this. Oh, and now I can skip again. Oh, wait, that's new. Wait, I'll go with you, but there's a blizzard outside. Are you just going out there alone? Let me go! The fuck is getting away? She's already gone! You said it yourself, she's a spirit, a demon, didn't you? You're only human. Are you planning to follow her alone at night in a blizzard? Oh, shit! Don't play! I know you won't stop, but at least take me with you. Rin has a strange expression on her face. Okay, get dressed quickly! We ran out of the house. Everything is covered with snow, and the layer is getting thicker with each passing minute. I'm trying to stay close to Rin and not lose sight of her, although it's difficult at times. Whatever she's up to, I don't want to leave her alone, especially now. We don't find any footprints. Maybe they got covered in snow, or maybe Kumi just didn't leave them. She's a spirit after all. The snowfall is getting heavier. I can barely move my feet.
Rin, I'm gonna lock you, please. Let's go back, please.
You should have stayed home. I shouldn't have taken you with me. Rin, you're shaking. Not at all.
Why did you always get my way?
Well, someone has to. You come with no brakes included, damn it.
I'll be fine.
I touched Rin's shoulder.
I mean it, Rin. Let's go back. No way. I have to follow the track while it's fresh. Oh, come on, Rin. Do you even see any actual tracks? Because I don't. But the fox says...
Forget the fox! We won't find her in a blizzard like this anyway!
There should be something else we're missing. And we won't fight it either if we end up freezing to death. That won't help anyone.
I have to admit it, but you're probably right.
There actually might be a good reason for your cranium to be that thick. Hey now! Stop targeting my cranium already!
When you finally go back home.
We then drink lots of hot chocolate and have a movie night. Frankly, we don't find anything we missed, except maybe the fact that we both needed a friend for a long time now. Can't say we turned into besties overnight, but small steps, you know. Despite Rin's expectations, nothing weird happens to us anymore. We wait a week. Maybe it's the new protective seals Rin put up everywhere, or maybe Kumi really did manage to fix everything. Guess I'll never know now, although I kinda want to. The haunting stopped as soon as Kumi left, but I somehow don't feel like she was a bad spirit after all. I wonder if she's okay out there. Sometimes when I feel like I've cooked too much, I put munchies on the open window. They are usually gone by nighttime. I know, that's probably the birds. Or maybe it's her. I start making my own manga after all. Well, not really my own, but the stories in it are all mine. Every last word! Drowning turned out harder than I thought it would be. Luckily, Rin had a solution. She introduced me to an artist who moved here a few years ago to paint local landscapes. She's a little shy, but incredibly cute. We got along great, and our manga is quickly gaining popularity online. Bone-chilling, spine-tingling stories from a mysterious girl who lives with her friends in a tiny town at the edge of the world. And wouldn't trade it for anything else.
Twin Pines. But damn it, I know much. I don't get that.
No. What if I say no? But why? No. This cannot be. I can't believe this. We must be together. Whoa! For the sake of us all.
How about no?
Refuse! The barking leaps out of the fog, getting louder and louder. They are coming. They know where you are. Rancid hot air burns at the air.
The moth snaps its teeth. Okay.
I'll leave the book this time. I think it's better if I just leave. I don't want Ren to have any weird ideas about me. Of any kind. Besides, I can barely stand myself. I just want to wrap myself in a blanket and keep my eyes closed until noon. But I know that won't do. I need to bathe first, or I'll have to share my bed with a clod of cupboard dust. Ugh, and I still have some furniture left waiting to be put in place. Existence is suffering! No. So that's how it is. I'm sorry. I won't bother you again.
What will happen now, since I chose all the options? I don't know.
I'll go with the same option again. Because I don't want anything bad to happen to you. I'll be fine. I hold my hand to her. Please, let's go back. But who's going to take care of this town if you freeze to death in some stupid snowstorm? But I was going to take care of me! I'm going to fall into some snowbank and I won't thaw until the spring arrives. From what I've heard, it comes very late here. Ren takes my hand and squeezes my cold fingers gently. Okay. I don't know how I'm going to help you with the house now, but okay. I'll take up something. Hey, kissing! We cling to each other, sharing our warmth. Even though Ren is really cold, I can feel her hot breath on my cheek. We will take up something. Together. I'm really scared.
Seems like you can walk through the worst of snowstorms if you're not doing it alone. We're going home. Despite Rin's expectations, nothing weird happens to us anymore. We wait a day, two, a week. Maybe it's the new protective seals Rin put up everywhere.
We can skip right.
Guess I'll never know, and honestly, I don't care. What's important is that after all that happened, Rin and I became really close. You know, we can always count on each other, and we don't hesitate to share our desired spears and dreams and kings. Sometimes this leads to the most amazing outcomes. For example, when I told Rin I had a dream to study abroad.
Hmm? Are you serious?
Yes. I think I'll be more useful to this town if I have a better understanding of what's going on outside of it. Rin explained her wish to her family and even convinced them to help both of us. We have been preparing for a long time, and now...
I passed! I am accepted!
And you? Let's see. I opened my letter. Well, I'm sorry to say this, but... I'm going to take the window seat of the plane!
You wish!
We'll have to pass behind us and see and have the whole world ahead.
Neat!
Setting begins. Mm-hmm. Ending 3 out of 6.
I'll talk to Kumi this time. I move closer to Kumi.
She turns into a small mound under the blanket. Sleeping.
Kumi, stop sleeping! Kumi's well awake!
Kumi yawns. For a moment, I can see her small, pointy fangs. Well, maybe a little sleeping. How are you feeling?
June is worried about Kumi.
Kumi is very pleased.
June doesn't have to worry.
Kumi is a very tough kitsune. Rin helps.
Did you forgive Rin?
Kumi, I've been wanting to ask you something for a long time. But it's, well, kinda weird. And it might upset you, I guess. Kumi chews sleepily on the blanket. Okay, it doesn't seem to be the right time. I'm about to get up, but Kumi grabs my hand. I didn't expect Kumi can move so fast, even half asleep. That's probably the same moment foxes used to catch mice under the snow.
Eh?
Ask. Kumi doesn't mind. Okay. Anyway, the Fukuyama clan did a lot of damage to your family, didn't they? Were you able to forgive Rin?
Kumi can answer, but the answer will be kind of weird.
And it might upset June.
Kumi thinks so.
Kumi will answer if June promises not to get upset.
Okay. Good.
Kumi wanted to kill Rin. Very badly. My palm in Kumi's hand suddenly feels cold and stiff. Is June upset? I shake my head, but my insides clench. But it's not that simple. Rin is the first person to make Kumi offerings in a long, long time. That is not enough to forgive, but... Kumi thought she would first help in return, then kill. Then Rin helped more. And June would probably be upset if Kumi killed Rin. So Kumi thought she wouldn't kill Rin. But Kumi didn't forgive. Fluff and fury. What a scary picture.
Kumi told the truth.
June is upset. Kumi sad. Kumi should have been silent.
No, I... Thank you for telling me the truth, Kumi.
I'm not sure how I do feel if I were you, but... It wasn't Rin's fault. Your family was treated terribly, but it was done by our people, a long time before Rin was born.
Sure, Rin can be very difficult at times, but she is a kind person and tries to do good things. It's just... We're only human. Sometimes it is very hard for us to distinguish good from bad. Please give her a chance.
Could you do that?
Kumi's ears twitch.
Kumi will tell June one thing. Kumi tried to figure out how she could find the spirits in the woods, but she was having no luck. Kumi tried and tried, until she lost all her strength. Then she fell into the snow and couldn't get up. It was very dark, cold, lots of snow. Kumi thought she would never see anything but snow again. Kumi thought she would never see princess again. Kumi felt the darkness calling to her. But then in the midst of the darkness and the snow, Kumi saw a light. Big, beautiful, round light. Kumi thought princess had come for her, and so Kumi decided to fight on. Kumi, I'm very sorry, but... Yes, Kumi remembers. Not only princess knows how to make light, the lantern knows how to make light, too. Kumi also knows how to make light, though not so big, but very hot. Would you like to see? Let's not do it in the house. It's fine, Kumi will show 1 hour time. Kumi gets out from under the blanket and takes my hand. Kumi understands that June has no tail and that she is not a princess. It doesn't matter. June gave Kumi hope. June helped Kumi a lot. Kumi is very grateful to June and will try to help her in return really bad, hard. Please, don't try really hard. You don't want to end up in a snowbank again, do you? I was really scared for you. You could have died. Kitsuna don't die. Kitsuna fade away. But then they can't come back again if they really want to. That's what Princess said. I see. What does June think? Princess wouldn't lie to Kumi, would she? She wouldn't? I think she was telling the truth. Kumi thinks so too. Kumi will look for Princess. Even if it's going to take a very, very long time. Kumi is patient. Sometimes. I'll help you search. I don't know what I can do, but I really want to help. June is so nice. Kumi likes June. I like you too, Kumi. Kumi knows. Why am I blushing? Kumi would like to help June too. Would June mind? No, of course not. Who would refuse? God. Kumi, what are you doing? June didn't like it? June liked it, but it's for good luck. Also, it feels nice. Kumi thinks so. This kissing me all of a sudden, this isn't just right.
Why?
It's like... Darn! Why does every girl in this household think it's okay to kiss me on their whim just because they're cute? June thinks Kumi is cute? Well, yes, but... Kumi did her best. Kumi has a question though. Huh? What is it? Can Kumi kiss June once more now that Kumi and June know each other properly? You can kiss me all you like, Kumi.
Woo!
Kumi curls into a happy fluffy ball and falls asleep at June's side. For a long time, June listens to her soft, even breath smiling at something, unable to believe in what just happened. Is everyone ready? Oh, it's the same. What if I say nothing? I'm trying to, but I can't find the right words. I just don't know what to think. It was as if Rin could hear my thoughts. Say what you will, and I probably won't deny it. You have the right to be angry. But I think I can still help, even though I don't have many magical powers. After all, what I do have is my knowledge. We already know what we're dealing with, which makes things much easier. I have a plan, and I'm going to do the best I can. What if it doesn't work? You think. But what if it doesn't work again? Will I end up in a house full of furious ghosts? First, I will try my best to ensure your safety.
So you weren't right before, were you?
K-
Cannot hang on every word, please? I'm burning my soul here.
It's not easy, you know. Yeah, thanks. I can feel it's pumping me up with positive energy. Back to what I was saying. There are no other real exorcists in my clan right now. I was supposed to take my grandmother's place, but... Well, you already know. I'll use my family connections to find a strong exorcist and bring them here. This will take some time, so while we wait, why not try to try and deal with the situation ourselves? But the evil spirits... Jun, evil spirits will always be evil. They don't need a special reason for it. They cause more harm and they get stronger. If we don't do something about it, they'll get stronger by sucking out your life energy. Ooh, what am I? A protein shake or something? Yeah, pretty much that. We need to act. That way we'll have the upper hand. I promise. You can't promise that! You're probably right. But still, I can promise I'll do my best. Alright then, let's give it a try. Rin jumps from her seat energetically. Good! I will renew the protective seals and perform a purification ritual. That should be enough to get us through the night. Now we rest, and tomorrow we'll have both hands on this fox. For some reason, I remember that scene at the TV. Yeah. Rin's voice is cheerful, but I get a feeling she's trying a bit hard. I think she's still feeling uneasy. Thanks, Rin. You know, Rin. Whatever it is that moves you, I wanted to say thanks. Yo, at least you're trying to help me. I'm glad I don't have to go through all this alone. Thank me once the house gets quiet.
Ah, can you at least accept gratitude in a way that doesn't make me want to slap you?
Okay, I'm sorry. Thank you for saying that. It means a lot to me. It really does.
I'll pretend I believe you. Hey!
What? Did you think you were the only one allowed to do that? Alright, oh, we can skip.
Don't move! Maybe there's something I can do? Only one option, maybe there's something I should do, but my feet are rooted to the ground. I can't leave the safe circle of salt. In the end, I just do what I'm told. Isn't that right? The right thing to do.
I come to my senses in a hospital. The doctors say my life is not in danger, but it will take me a long time to recover. It turns out some local folks found me in the woods. I was in the state of shock and severely hypothermic. I tried asking about Rin and even Kumi, though I sensibly don't mention her foxy features, but no one remembers any matching patients. Through the small window of my hospital room, I watched winter finally give way to spring. No visitors come to see me, only once some woman gets to the wrong room. After I'm discharged, I go home. It's strangely empty and peaceful. No more weird noises. No more visions. The house next door stands quiet and peaceful too, and at night its windows remain dark. There's not a crumb of food in the kitchen, so I go out to the store. I walk between the familiar shelves and stare at the colorful packs. Then I take a really long time choosing the noodles, even though they are not what I need at all. Hello, June dear. Haven't seen you in a while. To tell the truth, I've heard you've gotten into the hospital and got plenty worried. The weather is just terrible this year. How are you feeling now, honey? Yes, I'm sorry. Can I ask you something?
Of course, Jun. What is it?
Say, have you seen Fukuyama Rin lately?
Fukuyama Rin? I don't recall the name. She's not from around here, is she? What?
What do you mean? Rin lives here with my parents. With her parents. They also have a sawmill.
Jun, dear, you must be mixing things up.
The Fukuyama have no daughters.
What?
Something ends.
What? I can't seem to be getting the memes.
No! What am I doing wrong? I can't get average joy or
appreciator memes.
God damn it! Whatever the case, they exist, but I can't get them because I'm too uncultured. Whatever the case, the game's done. Completo.
Right?